My dad was my first influence in music, and he was my hero. I was a classical pianist from age 7. I rebelled against my classical upbringing when I got to about 15 because it was so prim and proper. Every 15-year-old boy had the Guns N' Roses posters. My mother would pull them down and put Virgin Mary up instead. When I got in my 20s, I went back to those early influences of classical and opera, where you can sing really, really quiet. And then in two breaths later, you're at 140 decibels. My dad, since the beginning of this show, I've never seen him so happy.
I'm very proud of David.
And I said, I love you, Dad. And he said, you're the best. To be praised and validated by your hero is the ultimate prize. Winning this show would be the ultimate platform to start a career, a real career. It would be a whole new life, the life I've always wanted.
Performance that he hopes will win him this competition tonight. Put your hands together for David DeVito. You had the audience on their feet. They absolutely love that. Your finals performance was Ness and Dorma. You nailed that. It must be so much pressure to have to back up after a performance like that.
Totally, totally. It's an absolute blessing that I'm here today, and I'd like to thank everyone in Australia who voted for me, and this was really a song for them, for bringing me here. Thank you.
How about you, mate?
I really like you, David. I think you're awesome. Last week's performance in the grand final showdown was probably, and I say probably, the best performance so far by anybody on the show.
Wow, thank you.
And I think for me, the negative side to that is that you had such a massive job tonight to compete, because that was just, last week was just flawless. It was a great performance tonight, but when it goes to grand finals, I think your curse is that your performance last week, nobody's going to beat that. And I still watch that back. I got tears. Nobody's made me cry in this show except for you.
Thank you.
I would just say, no matter what happens, I would really steer back into that operatic. Steer back into that operatic thing, because nobody can do it like you.
Thank you. All right? Thank you. Yeah.
Danny.
I have to say you got me with the opera as well, but that was an epic, epic performance. You could see how much you love seeing that up there. And you know what? It's worth a shot to get up here and say, look, I can do all of these things. You know, where is this going to lead me? Mm. You're definitely going to be singing and performing as a career. That's what you're going to do.
How did it sound for you, Kyle? Your thoughts on the big fella?
Sounded fantastic to me. Now, I actually hate that song more than any song on earth. But when you sung it, I just fell into it all because, you know, and I like you and I've gotten to like you over the last few weeks. And I have to agree with Brian and Danny as well. The opera, when you do opera, it's just flawless and it's you, 100% you. But I think you did a sensational job on that. For a song that I hate for me to like, you must be doing something right, mate. Good luck.
Thank you.
Did you enjoy that performance? Inclusive within the audience, and to make David's dream come true, him this year's winner by calling 1-802-55-3334 or SMS David to 199-7772. And if you can't get enough of seeing the both of us stand side by side, make sure you vote for David DeVito.